Somebody shout hallelujah. Let's give him praise. Let's adore him. Let's worship him. Let's magnify him. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the beginning and the ending. The Almighty God. The one that is worthy of our praise. Wherever you are, please just worship God. Let's begin to give him praise. Let's begin to give him glory. Let's begin to worship him. If you have favorite songs, begin to sing those songs unto the Lord. Call him by his names and just exalt him. Just tell him, Lord, I love you. I want you to verbally acknowledge God in your life right now. I want you to verbally tell him, Lord, I love you. Lord, I appreciate you. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto the Most High. You don't need to close your eyes if you are driving. Just thank the Lord where you are. Maybe you are at work, maybe you are on the way, maybe you are in the kitchen, wherever you are, just praise him. Just tell him, Lord, I appreciate you. Lord, I bless you. Lord, I glorify your name. Do you remember those 10 lepers? Only one came back. Jesus is still looking for the other 9 up to tomorrow. He said, where are they? So if God has been good to you, he expects appreciation. He expects thanksgiving. He expects gratitude. He expects us to express it. Don't just think about it. Don't just imagine it, but verbalize it. Say it out and say, Lord, I thank you. On behalf of myself, on behalf of my family, on behalf of my nation, I thank you. Somebody go ahead and just worship the name of the Lord. What a wonderful opportunity we have to gather together on this platform again. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Lord Almighty, we exalt you. Lord Almighty, we adore you. Lord Almighty, we appreciate you. Lord Almighty, we lift high your name. There is no God like you. You are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the beginning and the ending. Jehovah, we praise you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we give thanks. Amen. Let's sing this song. All power belongs to Jesus. Come on. All power belongs to him. All power belongs to Jesus. All power belongs to Hallelujah. All power belongs to Jesus. All power belongs to God. All power belongs to Jesus. All power belongs to him. There is power mighty in the blood. Oh, there is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. In the blood, there is power mighty in the blood. Hallelujah, there is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. Heaven and earth adore him. Angels bow before him. What a mighty God we serve. Serving a living God. We are serving a living God. Amen. Serving a living God. We are serving a living God. Amen. Serving a living God. We are serving a living God. Amen. Serving a living God. We are serving a living God. Amen. Serving a mighty God. We are serving a mighty God. Oh yes, serving a mighty God. We are serving a mighty God. Amen. Serving a healing God. We are serving a healing God. Amen. Serving a healing God. We are serving a healing God. Oh, serving a mighty God. We are serving a mighty God. Oh, serving a mighty God. We are serving a mighty God. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much, Pastor Eileen. Thank you so much, Coach Akinola. Thank you so much, ministers of God, people from different places all over the world. Thank you so much for joining tonight. Now, we have very important prayers to pray tonight. And I believe God, power will be released. I say power will be released. The power to soar above every circumstance of life. The power to rise. The power to shine. The power to move forward. The power to fulfill destiny. The power to get to the place of your glory will be released upon your life in the name of Jesus. And as the power of God is being released upon our lives, every evil power, every other power different to that of God that is resisting our advancement, they will be shaken and they will be shaken away in the mighty name of Jesus. As we pray together, there will be earthquake in your life. A shaking is going to take place in your life. Can somebody say amen to that? A shaking is going to take place. God is going to shake the foundation of your life, and he will shake away the shakeables in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As the power will be released, as we seek the Lord these 7 days in prayer, like it happened in Acts of Apostles chapter 16, the Bible says, as Paul and Silas, only two of them, as they were praying and praising God, just two of them. That is why I just need one person here to agree with me. I just need one person here to be serious with me. I just need one person here, somebody who really believes that the year 2020 should not end the way it started. Somebody who is expectant. Somebody who still trusts God, that God can lift you above every wind and storms of life. I just want one woman. I want one man. I want one young person, one child to agree with me. Jesus says, if two of us, I and you, if we agree together, when we agree together, he says, whatever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever we lose on earth will be loosed in heaven. He says, whatever we command will be established. I am looking for one person whose mind is made up. Somebody who is ready to move higher. Somebody who is ready to go forward. Somebody who is ready to cross boundaries and barriers. Somebody who is saying, I will not die like this. Somebody who is refusing to give up. You are the one I want to pray with these 7 days. I want you to make it a duty that as we have started together tonight, we will finish together next week, Thursday. The prayers we are going to pray this week, we walk in our life for this time. We walk in our life for the remaining of this year. And I want to tell you, we prepare us also for the year that is ahead, for the things that are ahead. Are you with me? Are you ready? Are you the person that God has sent me to at this time? Then if you are the one, it is time. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we stand upon the eternal word of God that can never be broken. As I and your people agree together on this platform from this very first day of this program. We submit ourselves to you, O Lord. We plead the blood of Jesus over our lives, that if there is anything in our life that will not allow our fellowship to be graced with your presence, Father, let the blood of Jesus Christ remove them from our lives in the name of Jesus. Every wrinkle, every spot, every blemish, anything in our life that the accuser of the brethren can point to that can hinder our prayer these 7 days, let the power in the blood of Jesus Christ take them away. Lord, I pray that everyone praying with me right now, you will sanctify our life. You will purge our life. You will remove every barrier from our life by the blood of Jesus. Father God of heaven and earth, that this time of prayer will not be a wasted time. This time of prayer will not be a wasted time. This time of prayer will not be a wasted time. Father, we crave and ask, oh God, that you bless us with your presence. For you have said, where two or three are gathered in your name, there you will be. Lord, I pray that you be with us right now. Holy Spirit of God, I pray that you fill me to overflow right now. I pray that you take over my intellect and my tongue right now. Holy Spirit, I pray that I will speak as your oracle. Make me your microphone, your megaphone right now. Speak through me, O God. Break chains, O God. Break barriers, O God. Uproot evil foundations, O God. As we pray together, as we look at your word together, under this 1 hour ministration, let yokes be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord God of heaven, whatever has not allowed us to soar above challenges, whatever have not allowed us to rise, Father, we put all of them together and we set them on fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God of heaven and earth, we are looking up to you for great testimonies from every continent of the world, from those that are watching right now, from those that will watch later. Jehovah God, I pray, let your power be released. 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 Let your name alone be glorified. Let the blessing be given to us. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let me show you a foundational scripture, and then I will tell you the reasons why we are gathering for these 7 days. I am happy to see pastors and senior ministers join me in this program. God bless you, sirs. God bless you, mas. God bless every one of you. You see, we need prayers. The Bible says we will continue to pray until our joy is full. Don't ever be weary. Don't ever be tired. Don't ever be discouraged. Don't let there come a time where the devil makes you feel that prayer is a waste of time. I'm in the book of Isaiah chapter 40. Isaiah chapter 40. I would like you to pick a pen and paper because I will give you some very important information quickly before we pray. Isaiah 40, and I'm going to read verse 31. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Amen. That is the principal scripture for this 7 days prayer. Why are we going to gather together for this 7 days prayer? What is our focus in this 7 days prayers? I will give you 7 reasons quickly. And that's why I said you need to get a pen and paper and take notes. Number one, we are gathered together to renew strength. We are gathered together to renew strength. For every believer, if we are going to enjoy the power of God, the power without ceasing, we must renew our strength in God from time to time. It's just like your phone. when your battery, the battery of your phone runs down, everything in the phone is intact, but you will not be able to make use of the phone. You will not be able to make calls. If your phone dies, you will not be able to receive calls. You will not be able to do anything with your phone. That phone will be useless. It will be as if you don't even have a phone at all. Why? Because the power has drained off. Now, many of us in our spiritual life, because of so many reasons, we have been drained of power. Do you know, those of you that knows the Lord very well, do you know we used to pray a prayer for ministers of God after they have ministered? We used to pray for them that the Lord will refill them, that the Lord, the virtue that have gone out of them, that the Lord will refill that virtue. It is not an ordinary prayer. It is not a routine prayer. It is a very important prayer, because as a minister of God, as you release, as you give, as you pray, as you minister, as you bless people, power is going out of you. Even you as a believer, that you are not a pastor, that you are not a minister, as you do things, power is going out of you. So just like your phone, just like the power goes down, the same way the power goes down. If you watch the ministry of Jesus Christ, you will notice that Jesus will always spend time in prayers, especially in the night. He will withdraw from people. He will go to a mountain. He will go to a quiet place. In fact, if you study the New Testament, the Gospels, you will observe that after every major miracle, Jesus withdraws and go to draw. So we withdraw to draw. Write that down. We withdraw to what? To draw. You have to withdraw to draw. If you don't draw, you will not be able to give when it comes to a time. So one of the things we are here to do is to renew strength. Number two, we are here to receive fresh insights, fresh revelation. We are here to receive fresh insight. Yes, God spoke to us last year about this year. God spoke to us in the beginning of this year. God is still speaking. For us to be able to soar, for us to be able to achieve God's plan and purpose for our lives, we need to hear him again. We need to get instruction on a daily basis. We need to know the mind of God for our lives, because from time to time, God wants to guide us. Many people are still working with the information they received last year. Meanwhile, God is already telling them and showing them new things that they need to follow, new things that they need to do. So number two, in these 7 days, we want to receive fresh revelations, fresh ideas, fresh insights. And I pray for you, if you will say a good amen, before the 7 days ends, God will give you fresh revelations. God will give you fresh ideas about your family, about your finances, about your future, about everything that concerns your life. Can I hear you say amen? God will give you fresh ideas. He will speak to you. Maybe you have been confused about what has been happening about COVID-19 and how things have scattered. And how, yes, God will speak to you. When God speaks to you, he gives you new instruction. Do you remember when the famine arose in the days of Elijah? God told him, go to the brook Cherith. I will take care of you there. And he went there and it was fine. There was water. And the Bible says that the bird will bring him food in the morning and bring him food in the evening. Divine provision. Everything was going on well until something happened. The brook dried up. And Elijah was wondering, what is going to happen? He heard the voice of God. I'm praying for somebody, before this 7 days ends, you will hear the voice of God. God will speak to you clearly about your business. He will speak to you clearly about your spiritual life. He will speak to you clearly about those challenges that you are facing. God will speak to you clearly. That is the focus of this 7 days prayer, sir. That is the focus. We want to receive new strength. We want to receive new information, new direction. In the midst of that confusion, the voice of God came to Elijah and told Elijah, arise, go to Zarephath. I have prepared somebody there, a widow, that will take care of you. If he had remained with the old information, of going to Cherith, he would have died there. But because while he was in Cherith, he had God again. God told him, now, arise, go. That's how God leads us. He speaks to us from time to time. He speaks to us from season to season. He speaks to us from situation to situation. May God speak to you. I can't hear you. May God speak to you. I say, may God give you direction. In the name of Jesus. Number three reason why we are gathering together for these 7 days is to recover all losses. To recover all losses. Somebody type on the screen, I will recover all losses. I will recover all. Say, I will recover all. Why we are gathered together, where we are going to be praying for these 7 days, is to recover all. May you recover all. In the name of Jesus. Everything the devil has stolen from you, you will recover all. Spiritually, financially, materially, maritally, psychologically, in any form, in any way, you will recover all. Is it possible to recover all? Yes. That was what God told David in that book of 1 Samuel chapter 30. He said, you will certainly recover all. This word is for somebody. You have suffered so many losses this year that even you yourself, you are tired. You are tired, but you will recover all. Concerning your health, you will recover. Concerning your finance, you will recover. Concerning everything about your life, you will recover. I was reading something earlier today that was, the statement was credited to one of the senior person in WHO, World Health Organization. And that person said, even though we are tired of COVID, but COVID is not tired of us. In other words, they are saying, try to keep yourself safe. COVID is still out there. So many losses have happened because of COVID. But I stand as the voice of God for your life at this hour. Whatever you have lost, you will recover in the name of Jesus. Number four reason why we are going to be praying for these 7 days is to reconnect with the Holy Spirit. To reconnect with the Holy Spirit. When we reconnect with the Holy Spirit, power will come. For those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Jesus told them in Acts chapter 1 verse 18, he said, you will receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. Number five is to relaunch our vision with faith. To relaunch our vision with faith. As we wait upon the Lord and he gives us fresh insights, fresh revelations, then we will go again. We will walk again. We will make effort again. I am praying for somebody that is serious with me on this platform right now, that God will give you the power to rise again. Somebody prophesy over your life, say, I will rise again. Somebody prophesy over your life, say, I will shine again. Somebody prophesy over your life, say, I'm going forward again. Yes, he is going to give us power to relaunch our vision. Every vision that is dead, every vision that is dead, the Lord Almighty will give you power to move again in the name of Jesus. Number six reason why we are gathering together on this platform is to rend to pieces every satanic plan. To rend, R-E-N-D, means to tear to pieces, Every document that is written against you, every ordinance working against you, every plan of the devil working against you, the purpose of this 7-day program is to tear them to pieces, to rend them to pieces. And number seven, the seventh reason why we are going to be here for these 7 days is to reign. Hallelujah. You are going to reign and rule over your enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. You are going to reign and rule over every situation in the mighty name of Jesus. You are going to reign and rule over every circumstances of life in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody say, I will reign. Yes, you will reign. R-E-I-G-N. I will reign. I will reign. I will reign. I will reign. Yes, that is dominion. He said, you are going to have dominion. That's where I'm going very quickly right now. We are going to be looking today, the power to fulfill purpose. Power to fulfill purpose. It's a prayer meeting, so I'm going to be fast. But I think I need to lay the foundation of why we are here for these 7 days. Number one, to renew strength. Number two, to receive fresh Insights and revelation. Number three, to recover all. Number four, to reconnect with the Holy Spirit. Number five, to relaunch our vision with faith. Number six, to rend and tear every plan of Satan against our life. Number seven is to reign in Christ. We reign here, we reign thereafter. Now let me go to today's word. Power to fulfill purpose. What is the meaning of power? Power is the ability to do something or to act in strength. Power means strength. Power means force. There are so many scriptures that talk about God being the custodian of all power. But there is just one scripture I want to show you because of time. In the book of Psalm 145. Power belongs to God. All power belongs to God. Let me quickly take you there. Psalm 147 verse 5. He says, great is our Lord, and of great power. His understanding is infinite. Great is our Lord, and of great power. All power belongs to God. What does it mean to soar? To soar means, or the word soar means, maintain height in the air without flapping wings. To maintain height in the air without flapping wings or using engine or without flapping wings or using engine power. That is to soar. If you watch the eagle, if you have studied about the eagle, that is one of the strength of the eagle. The eagle does not flap her wings in the storm. She just spreads her wings and glides and enjoy and move on the strength of the storm. The storm that was supposed to disorganize our flight becomes the platform for advancement. I am prophesying over somebody. Everything that has been working against you will begin to become the platform for your advancement in the mighty name of Jesus. Genesis chapter 50 verse 20. Genesis 50 20. Joseph said to his brothers when they came to apologize to him after the death of their father and to plead for mercy. He said, you don't need to beg me. The evils you planned, God turned it around for good. It was the evil you thought you did that pushed me, that moved me to this level that I am now. I am prophesying over somebody's life. Excuse me. Every evil thing the enemy has done against your life, the Lord is using them to move you forward. The Lord is using them to push you ahead. The Lord is using them to advance your purpose. The Lord is using them to advance your cause in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, in Genesis chapter 1, I'm talking quickly about power to fulfill purpose. Power to fulfill purpose. Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. Hear what the word of God says about the purpose of our existence. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful, be and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. And God blessed them. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Because you are created and made in the image of the Lord, you are blessed. He blessed them. And then he gave these five instructions, five commandments, five orders. They were words of authority over every human being that he made. He commanded you to be fruitful. So that is going to be our area of prayer tonight. Get ready to pray. We are going to look at these five areas very, very quickly. You need to know God's purpose for your life. When you know the purpose of God for your life, you need the power of God to fulfill that purpose. And that is why power is very, very important. Okay, look at the first instruction. He said, be fruitful. Be fruitful. To be fruitful is to be productive. God wants your life, your family, your ministry to be productive. God wants things to grow in your hand. And that is my prayer for you at this hour. You will be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Anything working against your fruitfulness, the power in the name of Jesus will consume them. Anything working against your fruitfulness, the power in the name of Jesus will consume them. Anything working against your advancement, the power in the name of Jesus will consume them. In the mighty name of Jesus, God wants you to be fruitful. To be fruitful. Now, if you look at, there are so many forces that fights and attack fruitfulness. You can look at the plant, for example. When you plant a seed, that seed needs some things to happen before she can come out of the ground. If that seed has life, if that seed has nourishment, then that seed will begin to germinate. But that seed will need power to push out of the ground, to push off the soil on her so that she can see the light, so that she can grow. So for us to be fruitful, we need power, the power of God to push. We need the power of God to be fruitful. That is why so many people will labor and there will be nothing to show for it. That is why the Bible says, except the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain that builds it. When the blessing of the Lord comes upon your life, comes upon your ministry, comes upon your business, comes upon your work, you will become fruitful. And that is going to be one of our serious prayers tonight. The anointing to be fruitful is coming upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Because that is the plan and purpose of God for your life. That what you are doing should grow. That your life should grow. That there should be advancement in what you are doing. And whether the devil likes it or not, you will be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Number two, he commands us to multiply. To multiply is to increase. To multiply is to add value. Now listen to me. God doesn't expect us to remain where we were last year, this year. And he doesn't expect us to remain where we are this year, next year. He wants increase. He wants us to multiply. He wants to see the fruits of our work. He wants to see the fruit of our labor. And that is the reason why we need power. Because if you are going to multiply, you need power. The power to multiply is coming upon your life in the name of Jesus. I remember we were preparing for a conference some years ago, and we were preparing material. We were trying to make copies of those materials that we will give to the pastors coming to the conference. Okay, we have this duplicator, two of them that we were using to run the material. And suddenly, the electricity was cut off. Also, we said we have no problem. We had a generator. We had the generator. The generator was okay. There was fuel. So we quickly went and put on the generator. And then we started to work. Not up to 10, 15 minutes. The generator packed up. The generator stopped working. Now, we had material. We had paper. We had the duplicators. But we do not have power. And the work stopped. And we were confused. And it was late. So we started to call for the generator engineer. Please. He said, look, I can't come tonight. Let me come tomorrow. And we said, please. We can't wait till tomorrow. We have a lot of things to do. We want to duplicate these things. And we need power. I pray for you. The power to multiply is coming upon your life in the name of Jesus. See, when there is no power, you can't increase. When there is no power, there can't be an advancement. Well, that's why so many of us, even though we have the skill, we have the talent, we have the ideas, we are not seeing progress. It's because there's no power. When power comes, things will change. Reluctantly, this engineer answered our request, and he came that evening. He spent some time on the generating cell, and life came, power came, and the work that has stopped continued. And we were able to do what we want to do. Why? Because there was power. You see, when you lose power, you lose productivity. When you lose power, you lose fruitfulness. When you lose power, you lose usefulness. I pray for somebody here. God is restoring every power and grace that you have lost in your life in the name of Jesus. Number three, God commands, he said, replenish the earth. Replenish the earth. To replenish means to make full or complete again. To make full or complete again. To replenish means to supply what is lacking. To supply what has been used up. Listen to me, friend. You are a blessing to your world. God sent you here to add up to people's life. God sent you here for a purpose. God sent you here to affect people positively. That is why when you are praying, don't just pray to be blessed. Pray to become a blessing. That God, let my life bless others. That was what Jesus meant in Matthew chapter 5 when he said, you are the light of the earth. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. See, God wants you to add value to your family. God wants you to add value in that working place where you are working. God wants you to add value in your church. You should not just be a figurehead. You should not just be just one of the number wherever you find yourself. Wherever you find yourself, your life should be relevant. Your life should add value. Your life should bring meaning. When you are not around, they should miss that you are not there. Is somebody hearing me? You should not just be a waka pass that you are just passing by. No, your life should add value. That is one of the prayers you should pray for yourself, because you see, our lifetime here is short, but that short time that God has given us, he expects us to make impact. The anointing to make impact in your life, the Lord is releasing it upon you in the name of Jesus. Number four, he wants us to subdue the earth. He wants us to conquer our territory. He wants us to overcome. What does that mean? In your area of calling, God wants you to shine there. You will shine. Are you a singer? Take it serious. You will shine there. You should not just play with it. Don't say, I'm just a choir in the church. No! If God has called you into the music ministry, pay attention to it and conquer that territory. Go and add to your knowledge. Advance in your skill. Is somebody hearing me? Are you an instrumental in church? Don't just sit down with that old knowledge you have. Things are advancing. Go and learn. Learn online. Look for people that know more than you. Conquer your ground. I am telling somebody here tonight, conquer your ground. Conquer your territory. Are you a financial person? What is your career? What is your field of specialization? Don't just sit down. Conquer your territory. Can somebody profess, I will conquer my territory? In other words, if you are a minister of God, you are a preacher of God, of the word of God, you need to study. Paul says, study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman that needs not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Don't just be a minister that is out of touch with God's word, out of touch with reality. You don't even know what is going on. The same message you preached 2 years ago is the same message you are preaching now. No! No! You need to conquer your territory. You need to conquer your area of calling. You need to become a major in your major. Is somebody hearing me? This is a generation where people and God are looking for competency. You must be sound. You must be competent in your area of calling. Are you in the area of drama ministry or evangelism ministry or teaching ministry or deliverance ministry or prayer ministry? Conquer your ground. Those of you that are career people, what is your line of profession? Don't sit down with that old certificate you received 15 years ago. Carrying. No. Go study. Overqualify. Is somebody hearing me? That is what will make you soar. That is what will make you rise above other people. Don't remain at the old level that you are. No, he says subdue. To subdue is to take possession, is to conquer, and not be for mouth. It's not just by saying it, it's by learning. What skill do you need to learn? You are there, you don't know how to drive. There is a car, but you can't drive. It's a disadvantage for you. Go and learn how to drive. You don't know how to use the computer. Go and learn how to use the computer. What are those things you need to learn? Learn. There is a lot of privilege and opportunity to add knowledge. Because if you are going to soar, you must have the power to subdue. That power is coming upon your life in the name of Jesus. Finally, he said, have dominion. I like this one. Have dominion. Rule. Dominate. Take charge of your life. Take charge of your life. Listen, the destiny, your destiny, of the destiny of your life is not in the hand of the government. No, it's not in the hand of the policy makers of the nation. No, your destiny is in the hand of the Lord. Your destiny is also in your hand. He gives us the power. He gives us the opportunity to dominate, to take charge. So I'm challenging somebody right now. It's time to take charge. Come on, somebody say, I am taking charge. I am taking over. No, I am not going to bow my head in shame anymore. I am not going to carry my head in my hands weeping anymore. I am not going to continue to feel sorry for myself anymore. Listen, you have cried enough. You have lamented enough. You have begged people for help enough. It's time to rule. It's time to reign. It's time to take possession. It's time to take position. It's time to dominate. It's time to rule. Hallelujah. I am believing God with you. God is going to restore every lost energy. You are going to receive the courage, the boldness to rise again in the name of Jesus. I know many of us have been beaten by life and several circumstances, particularly this year. Many bank accounts are in red. Many people don't have food to eat. Many people are facing several challenges. So many bills piling up and no money coming in. But listen, in the midst of all this confusion, we are going to reign. Somebody shout hallelujah. In the midst of all this trouble, we are going to reign. So today, the word of God says we are commanded to be fruitful, to multiply, to replenish the earth, to subdue the earth, and to what? And to reign. It's time to pray. First of all, I want you to thank the Lord. If there is any member of your family that is there with you, invite them to join you as we pray. Invite them to join you as we pray. Or you share this video with your friends. Let us pray. We serve a God that answers when we pray. He wants us to soar above our circumstances. Those circumstances that are meant to kill you, that are meant to drown you, they are the same circumstances on whose wings you will ride to greatness. Because God will give you the power to rise. He will give you the power to fly. He will give you the power to soar in the name of Jesus. But the first thing is that you must discover his purpose for your life. That his purpose for your life is that you will multiply. You begin to declare it. God's purpose for my life is that I will multiply, and I will. God's purpose for my life is to increase and multiply. I will. Is to be fruitful. I will. Is to replenish the earth. I will. Is to subdue the earth. I will. Is to have dominion. To have dominion over every situation. To have dominion over sicknesses and diseases. To have dominion over every powers of evil. To have dominion in every area of my life. Yes! That is the purpose of God for your life. Let's start with thanksgiving. I want you to raise your hands, if possible, to thank the Lord. Say, Father, thank you for your purpose for my life. Thank you for sending me to this world. Thank you for the salvation of my soul. If you are saved and you are born again. If you are not saved and born again, this is the opportunity to be born again. Because the power of God will only connect with you when you are washed in the blood of Jesus. So I want you to use this opportunity very quickly and say, Jesus, save me today. Wash me today. Thank you for the opportunity that I have to call upon your name today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Go ahead and give him praise. Let somebody praise the Lord. Let's thank him for how far he has helped us this year. Let's thank him for the opportunity we have to fellowship. Let's thank him because he has great plan, he has great thoughts, he has great program for our life. Yes, Father, we thank you. Father, we worship you. Father, we adore you. Thank you for those who are saved on this platform. Thank you for those who are giving their lives to you right now on this platform. Thank you for the precious blood of Jesus that washes and sanctifies us and qualifies us to come to your presence. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Okay, this is what we're going to do. Now, I want us to pray this prayer, and it's very, very important. Say, Father, show me where I am now. Show me where I am now. And this is the prayer. Show me the things I need to stop doing for me to fulfill purpose, and show me the things I need to start doing to fulfill purpose. Do you get the prayer? Say, Father, show me my life. Show me where I am. Minister to me. Show me the things I need to stop doing so that I can fulfill purpose. And show me the things I need to start to do so that I can fulfill purpose. Shall we pray in the name of Jesus? Almighty Father, like you revealed Isaiah to himself in Isaiah chapter 6, and he was able to see his errors and his mistakes, and he was able to ask for forgiveness, and you gave him a new beginning, and you gave him a new ministry. The same way, oh Lord, we come to you tonight. Please show us the areas in our lives where we are wrong. The things we are doing in our character, our attitudes, our behavior that will not help us to fulfill your purpose for our life. I pray for everyone on this platform with me that Holy Spirit, you begin to point to us those things in our life, those things we know but we don't give attention, that the devil is using to cripple and paralyze our advancement. Father, reveal to everyone on this platform. I pray that the Lord will show us, he will minister to us by his spirit, the things we need to stop to do, those things that God has been warning us about, we've been hearing in the word of God about, stop this, stop this, stop this, stop this. Every sin, every ungodliness, every unrighteousness, every weakness in character, every dishonesty. Father, I pray that you begin to show each of us those areas of our lives where we need to repent, where we need to return to you. Those attitudes, those small, small things, that procrastination and oversleeping and overeating and laziness and talkativeness and useless spending. Anything in our life, oh Lord, that is not helping our advancement. Lord, I want you to begin to show each of us those things now, and you give us the power to stop doing them in the name of Jesus. Father, we also pray that you begin to show us, oh Lord, the things that we need to start to do now, the things we need to start to do from now, as we begin to take our life serious, as we begin to take the purpose for God, of God for our life serious. Father, I pray for everyone on this platform that you begin to show us those things we need to start, those things we need to work on, those things we need to improve on, those things we need to spend time on, those things we need to go for, that will help our advancement in the name of Jesus. Father, help us in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. The second prayer is very important. Now, these prayers, pray these prayers. After this platform, pray these prayers. Until we meet tomorrow, pray these prayers. I want you to say, Father, show me where I'm going. The Lord might have showed you before, but I want you to ask him to show you again. You see, when there is a vision, when you have an understanding of your destination, when you know the plan of God for your life, it helps you to be focused. It helps you to look away from every distraction. Do you remember Joseph? He saw a vision of the future, and it was that vision that kept him on track. When he got to Potiphar's house, he said, no, this is not what I saw in my dream. When he got to the prison, he said, no, this is not where I saw in my dream. I must just be passing by here. Until he got to the palace, he remained steadfast. I want you to say, Father, show me. Open my eyes of understanding. Let me begin to see you clearly your purpose for my life. Cleanse me, wash me, touch my mind, renew my mind, renew my mind. Let every, yes, I like that. That sister is already praying. That is the spirit. Go ahead. Say, Lord, renew my mind, renew my thinking. Let every thinking, every thought of fear leave me. Let every thoughts of unbelief leave me. Let every thoughts that have germinated and grown in my spirit from the negative things I've been fed with from my childhood about myself, let those things disappear. Let me begin to understand your plan. Let me begin to understand the greatness of your purpose for my life. In the mighty name of Jesus, as I'm praying right now, somebody here, you are praying with us, your spirit is depressed. It's like you are tired of life. You are tired of life. You are so down in your spirit. Even you are not really praying. You are just managing to be part of this prayer. Listen, I want you to cast out that spirit right now. Command depression to leave you alone. Yes, as you are praying, God is going to set you free from that spirit right now. That spirit that has made you so weak and so weary, you are not looking for any, you are not excited about life. You are not excited about anything. You are just there. Ah, you are not denying God, but you are just tired. Ah, command that weariness to leave you. Command that tiredness to leave you. Command those fears, doubts, and unbelief and evil words. Command them to leave your mind. Yes, let every one of us pray and say, Father, open my eyes of understanding. Touch me. Touch my mind. Let me begin to receive. Let me begin to conceive. Let me begin to understand the great things that you have ahead for me, so that my attitude will change towards that. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. As we are praying, God is doing a very serious operation. Listen, this may not be the general kind of prayers we are praying before, but I've told you the seven reasons why we are praying this 7 days prayer. If you just joined us and you did not hear those seven reasons, I would like you to go back and watch from the beginning when we close this program. And you need to take those things serious. I may not be talking to everybody. It may just be one person. I just want one person that is desperate with God, one person that really want to have a testimony. It is that person I am talking to. I want us to pray that prayer again. You see, when our mind is beclouded, when we don't understand the words of God concerning our destiny, we will not be able to push. And when you can't push, like the seed that I mentioned the other time, when the seed is buried in the ground, the seed has to push. Has to push the earth off her head for her to see the light. You need the power to push, because when you are buried as a seed, you are not dead. You are going to germinate, but you need to push. So we need that power to push. And for us to push, our mind must be renewed. Some of us, people have said so many negative things about us from our childhood. They have made us feel that we are useless. We can't do anything, particularly our families and our friends. They've said some of us, they call us all kinds of negative names. And those things are working against God's plan for our life. I want you to ask the blood of Jesus. Say, blood of Jesus, circumcise and wash my heart, renew my mind. Let every negativity be wiped off from my spirit in the name of Jesus. Let every negativity be removed from my mind. Let my eyes, my spiritual eyes, become open. Somebody pray this prayer. Do you remember the Bible says, for the joy that was set before Jesus, he was able to endure the cross because he was seeing multitudes of people being saved. He forgot about the pain of the cross. When God opens your eyes and you see his plan and you see his agenda and you see his purpose for your life, I tell you, discouragement will go, fear will go, unbelief will go, energy will come, energy to go back to school, energy to go and learn again, energy to try again, energy to do ministry again. That energy will come. Say, Holy Spirit, wash my mind with the blood of Jesus, renew my spirit, remove every negativity from my mind, let my spiritual eyes become open. In Jesus' mighty name, we are free. The Holy Spirit is still asking us to pray that prayer. Maybe I will just give you the other prayer as an assignment. You go and pray on them till we come tomorrow. Do you remember that story? When the servant of Elisha was afraid when he saw the soldiers that surrounded the mountain. And Elisha prayed a prayer. He said, Lord, open his eyes. And the Bible said, when the Lord opened his eyes and he saw the host of angels, the host of the army of God on that mountain, oh my God, courage came back. He said, those who are with us, they are greater than those who have come against us. Immediately his fear disappeared. Unbelief disappeared. Doubt disappeared. See, when God opened your eyes and you see, you have a glimpse of what he plans for you, you will forget about the problem you have now. You will know that the problem you have now is just preparing you for glory. I want somebody to pray this prayer. Say, Holy Spirit of God, open my eyes. Open my eyes of spiritual understanding. Let me begin to see your plan. Let me begin to see your purpose. Let me begin to see your agenda for my life, for my future, for my marriage, for my ministry, for my career. Somebody pray. Holy Spirit, open my eyes of understanding. 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 Somebody pray. Open my eyes of understanding. Holy Spirit, open my eyes of understanding. Let me see. Let me understand. Let my spirit man receive clearly your plan for my life. I want to see it again, oh Lord. I want you to revive my spirit. Let me see. Let my eyes open. Let my eyes open. Let fear go. Let unbelief go. Let doubt go. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are free. Hallelujah. God has just broken the power of fear over somebody right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. God has just broken the power of fear over somebody right now. That fear is gone. That fear is gone. Courage is there. Strength is coming in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Okay, there's no time, but let's pray this prayer very quickly. Let's take those five things very quickly, one by one. He said, be fruitful. Say, I receive grace to be fruitful in every area of my life. Open your mouth in the name of Jesus. I receive grace to be fruitful. Grace for fruitfulness. I receive it. Power for fruitfulness. I receive it in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, I receive power to multiply, to increase. I receive power to multiply. I receive power to increase in the name of Jesus. I receive power to multiply. I receive power to increase in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, I receive power to replenish the earth, to be useful and relevant in my lifetime, in my generation. Say, I receive power to replenish the earth. I receive power for relevance. I receive power to add value. Somebody open your mouth and pray. Say, I receive the power of God to be relevant, to add value, to replenish the earth, to affect my generation positively. I receive that power in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are free. Number four, say, I receive power to subdue the earth. I receive power to conquer my territory, to overcome. I receive power. I receive power to major in my major. I receive power to rise in my career. I receive power to fulfill ministry. If you are a minister, come on, open your mouth and declare that. I receive power to subdue, to take kingdoms, to take nations, to take territories in the name of the Lord. I receive power to take territories in the name of the Lord. I receive power to fulfill my purpose in ministry, in life, in my business, in my marriage. Somebody pray. Come on, somebody pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number five, finally, I receive power to reign, to have dominion. Oh, no, 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 no. Sickness will not reign in my body. I receive power for good health, sound health in the name of Jesus. I receive power to reign financially. I receive power to reign spiritually. I receive power to dominate and to overcome and to conquer every situation of my life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Stretch your hands towards me. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to bless you for every man, every woman, every boy, every girl that have joined us on this platform tonight, the first night. Every power that is not of God, I command them to scatter by fire in your life. I pray that you receive the power to fulfill God's purpose for your life. In the name of Jesus, that you will be fruitful, that you will multiply, that you will subdue the earth, that you will replenish the earth, that you will reign and have dominion. In the name of Jesus, I pray that God will open your eyes of spiritual understanding, that even from this moment, the Spirit of God will begin to speak to you and begin to give you ideas of God and begin to show you the brighter future that He has for you, that you will rise in strength and God's name in your life will be glorified. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lord. A lot of deliverance has taken place. God is working on our minds. He's removing those clogs and barriers. Yes, God is going to lift your spirit. So pay attention. The Lord will begin to speak to you, whether in your dream or He will bring in thoughts and ideas to you. You know, and you can share with me. Inbox me. Whatever the Lord tells you, we can find time within the week to talk about it. And we can pray together. By the grace of God, we will do this again for 1 hour tomorrow. And when we are coming tomorrow, we should come with the faith and confidence in God that God will answer our prayer. Now, this is one prayer I want you to pray with the others who have prayed tonight until we come tomorrow. I will not fail in my divine assignment. Please pray that prayer. Apply it to every department of your life. I will not fail financially. I will not fail in my business. I will not fail in my ministry. I will not fail. I will not fail in my divine assignment. Thank you for coming. God bless you. Please share this video. Share this video. Share the advert for this program. Let's join together tomorrow. And of course, every evening we want us to give an offering. There is nothing too small to give. Nothing too small to give. So as the Lord leads you, you can give an offering. If you want to do that, just send me a message on inbox and we will give you the direction to do that and the Lord will answer your prayer. God bless you. God be with you. I'll be waiting to hear your testimonies in the name of Jesus. Glory be to the Lord.